as Kira's talking about in Britain, the lack of testing has led to a lockdown. Same thing happened here. Every time a bailout comes, I understand the importance of these bailouts to help working Americans who have been punished because of this. But you do wonder when economists and scientists look back at this, whether the United States' abject failure to get testing right early on and its refusal to take the World Health Organization's test kits and start in January when the president's intel community was warning
that's
him,
right.
You wonder if that's going to end up being a $1 trillion, a $2 trillion mistake, that we had to shut down the entire economy because we didn't have the testing, which required us and our leaders to be flying blind and not knowing who was infected, who wasn't, who needed to be isolated, who could still remain at work.
And the president ran through blatant warnings. It wasn't, you know, a kind of a Monday morning quarterbacking, looking back at a report that might have come across his desk. These are blatant warnings from around the world that the president had, that this White House had and decided to run through.
Well, and
decided to wing it.
I think one of the things that concerns me even more right now, because again, that was the past. We're worried about misinformation that's being spread right now. But there actually have even been in the past week, some of his media hacks who have been promoting more bad science, more bad medicine, like having entire segments suggesting that people in middle America are basically immune to this, that this is a New York problem, that this is not a problem in middle America, and having guests on that sit back and laugh at the thought that people in middle America need to be concerned by the coronavirus. They do need to be concerned. Whether you're talking about Detroit or Louisiana, whether you're talking about other places in middle America, there is a great need for concern there. We're hoping that the distancing is going to make a big difference. But for people to still be talking this way is the height of irresponsibility. And you know, Rush Limbaugh was on yesterday, I read. And of course, Rush Limbaugh was saying that this was nothing more than the flu. Yesterday, he came back on and said, this is pneumonia times 10 or pneumonia times 20, something like that. And no reference to the fact that he had lied to the American right. people several weeks before and told them there was nothing to do. I wonder how many people who are infected right now listen to that sort of talk and listen to people saying that it was a media hoax, that they're whipping people into a frenzy and overplaying this to try to get President Trump impeached. I wonder how many people are in the hospital today, how many people are infected today because they heard those lies in the media and they believed them. I wonder how many Rush Limbaugh listeners, if 20 million people still do listen to him every week, I wonder how many people depended on those lies, relied on him, and now find out that even he is saying this is pneumonia times 10 or pneumonia times 20.
It's going to be an important question.